My name is Verida Leandre, and I'm a third year PhD student at Brown University, and I work in the Mathiowitz Lab. I'm from the DC area in Maryland. My dad is an engineer and a management consultant. My mom's a teacher and a really good one, so hopefully one day I can be a good teacher too. My parents were really young when they had me, like 20 and 23, and so I was kind of along for the ride when they were like building their lives and their careers. When I was in first grade, I read Ben Carson's autobiography, and I kind of like, I finished the book, I put it down, and I was like, Mom, I'm gonna be a neurosurgeon when I grow up. And she was like, sure, six-year-old child, you should do that. And then I really just like, for the next 10 years, went full tilt into like doing everything I could to become a neurosurgeon. Where even in high school, I was part of a program that I worked at a hospital and I interned with an anesthesiologist and I got to go and like into the OR. So the grand goal is to develop a cell-based therapy for obesity. And what I'm trying to do is implant proteins to recruit a specific type of progenitor cell and then change those cells and encourage them to grow and become brown fat, which is similar to white fat that we have in our bodies, like here, storing. But instead of storing energy that you take in as food, it dissipates it as heat, like through cell intercellular reactions within mitochondria and stuff. One day, people will, if they are obese or predisposed for obesity or just want like a preventative measure to safeguard from obesity, they can have small patches implanted into their bodies as like an outpatient procedure that can amplify the amounts of brown fat in their body. And then instead of storing energy and becoming white fat, they can have more brown fat, and hopefully it'll cure the obesity they already have or prevent obesity from even starting. I think that my project is really interesting, but it's also really risky. So I'm building a lot on a single premise. Sometimes that is terrifying. But I think the chances for success are really great. Fascinating things to me are things like breast cancer that disproportionately affect women, or like heart disease that disproportionately affects people of a lower socioeconomic background, and teasing out why things happen to certain people, if it's not just like genetics or if it's environmental factors, is really important to me. So I guess the thing I like most about my project is that it's so interdisciplinary and I get to do a whole bunch of different things and learn a billion different techniques. Oh my gosh, we have so much fun in this lab. What's up? We have Disney Fridays, where on Fridays we are all princesses and we sing a lot of Disney music. I don't believe in the whole thing that you have to choose one thing and do that for the rest of your life. I chose to go to grad school because I think I'm getting a really particular set of skills, and I'm learning how to think through problems and how to set up and implement experiments and how to answer complex questions, and I'm learning how to deal with people on an interpersonal level.
It's strange because this deep tomato shows up yellow.
Oh, so it's partially just the objective. We can look at it on a different.
Okay.
So there's green and there is red. So it actually shows up really nicely in the red.
Okay.
But the orange allows us to see both the green because there's a bit more crossover.
Okay. Yeah.
My dad was born and grew up in Haiti. And so I've been to Haiti a few times. It was a very jarring experience for me to like see people with dysentery or really curable diseases. It definitely gave me a lot of perspective on my life and my problems. So, I mean, I grew up relatively privileged in a first world country, and you see people that have lost their homes and literally lost everything they have, including some family members. And I feel like if those people can still do things and live day to day, then I really don't have any excuses. Sometimes a small group of people make decisions that affect millions, and I think I have an interesting perspective on those issues, and I'd like to be a part of the group that decides how healthcare can be administered or how people interact with healthcare professionals. We're in a band.
You're in a band called Big Jim and the Sister Wives?
Yeah. Yeah. We are the Sister Wives.
We are the Sister Wives.
Is there a Big Jim?
No.
No, there's no Big Jim. Who needs a big gym these days anyway?
Not us.
Not scientists.
How did you end up in this band again?
I think we were singing in the surgery room one day.
Oh, yeah!
And there are, like, really good acoustics in that room.
It's the sound. The sound is amazing.
And I don't know what song it was, but it was...
Yeah, it was beautiful.
It was really beautiful.
And we took our show on the road.
I'm black and I'm blue. I'm covered in sorrow, but maybe I'll find the right words tomorrow. Blue skies above me, God's earth below. I know that I'm lucky, but I can't let you go.
I look at my project as like a huge Rubik's Cube. And I don't know about you, but I've never solved a Rubik's Cube. And one day I will solve the Rubik's Cube that is science.